it? It's Wednesday, I believe the 3rd, and I'm hunting the southern piece of my property this morning, in here after a different buck that my wife named Widowmaker. We also have 2 years of history with this deer, so I believe he's 3.5 as well. We have squirrels going crazy this morning. About 80 yards to my northwest here, I have gotten several pictures of this deer on trail camera. So it's again, I'm not pressuring my property. I'm kind of trying to hunt the perimeters and maybe catch them just going to feed or going back to bed. So here to my north, my north-facing slope, it is my primary bedding for my deer on my property, and I believe there's 2 or 3 big oaks in there that these deer are feeding on, but I don't know for sure because I haven't got in there. I haven't even actually walked any portion of my property this year, other than the perimeter, so I don't know if they're dropping for sure, but I'm assuming they are just based off my trail camera activity, and I might be about 80 to 90 yards from that oak. Historically, this spot has been good. Everything to my north here that I'm watching over has always had a really, really good sign. And then in this winter, I've been in the bedding area and saw quite a few nice buck beds. They use this top and then go down the north side to the field in the evening. But they also kind of mill around here and bed down to the south as well. So it's a beautiful morning here. It's pretty warm. I'm just wearing the Ascent subalpine pants and lightweight hoodie with merino bases on, and super comfortable. Today, I have my stuff together. I brought my SD card, I brought my camera arm, I have my adapter for my camera, so I don't have to hold the camera today. I do want to mention that always wear your safety harness, and for this morning, it's kind of crazy how it helped me. Hanging this mobile set because I'd have a stand here, and I slipped because I wear these mountain boots in the woods because they're comfortable. I don't really like leather boots, so I don't wear them too often. But the only problem with them is they're really, really hard leather, and they slip on the steps super easy. So as I was putting on my third step, I put it up, and went to step up on it, put all my weight on that right foot, and I had a good hold. But it went off, and it went off so hard, I went down quick. I always hug the tree and stay close to the tree. I've been doing this since I was 16, something like that. I've never fallen. I've had close calls, but I slipped, went down, and as I was falling, my harness, great, let's see if I can move the camera, the harness right here, caught on a step, and kept me from falling down the tree, banged my arm up on the step. Good Lord was with me this morning, and luckily I'm safe, not hurting, too bad, arms bummed up, but I'll be alright. So, multiple reasons to wear your safety harness, I always do, and I think I just need to wear different boots into the stand. That's been my problem. I've slipped twice this year with these boots on, so not good, but it's prime time right now. If I'm going to see him, it's going to be here within the next hour. 7:30 right now. I got in here about an hour before daylight just to make sure I didn't screw anything up. I keep hearing stuff, so I'm going to shut up and hopefully have a good hunt. There also is a buck in here named Booger. My daughter named him Booger. It's a 3.5-year-old as well. It's probably a 130-inch 8-point. So he's in this area, and so is Widowmaker. And we've been seeing them in the area pretty close, so they're here somewhere. Let's just hope we can catch up with them.
Guys, it's Friday, October 5th, which means it's my wife's birthday. So, originally had planned, I've got the mobile rig set up. I was going to take it out and hunt a little further in today, but I'm going to do the good husband thing and hunt a little short sit this morning since it's the only day that I'll get out this week to hunt. I'm just going to hunt the permanent stand I have. Lock on I have set up close that I hunted last week, the opening morning. Not really expecting much, but sometimes it's more about being out and just enjoying your time in the woods than it is expecting a buck to walk by. But putting yourself out there and being out there is better than not, so I think that's about it. It's going to be a little bit cooler today, so running the same clothes that I wore opening day, light merino bottoms and top, Apex pants, and I am going to run the Calvin Light vest underneath, so it'll be a little bit warmer. Be enjoying my sit. But it's going to be a short one this morning. I do have work, and I want to get back and spend a little time with Lisa and Juliet, so I'm going to get ready and go do this thing.
Thank you.
right, guys, it's Saturday. Another quick sit. I've got to work 10 o'clock, so I have to be at the shop. So I'll be in probably till 8:30 at the latest. Again, not really expecting much, just enjoying my time out in the woods. So it's what it's all about for me, especially early season, especially sitting close to home when I don't have very much time. So just enjoying being able to be out in the woods. So that's what I'm going to do.
Scent blowing is in this bedding area in front of me, so I'm not really concerned about what's in behind me. No matter what, your scent's going to blow somewhere, but I have the Ozonics blowing back behind me to help with my scent a little bit. I do want to mention that, you know, I'm not using this Ozonics as a I can hunt any wind type of situation. I use it just to help cover up my scent, and since I've been using it, I haven't had any deer blow or snort or anything like that since I've been running it. Doesn't mean that there isn't a deer downwind that I didn't see because it smelled me, but anytime they're close and directly downwind, they know something's up, but they can't recognize that it's a human. Or if they do recognize that it's a human, they think you're further away than what you are, or it was a few days old. It's kind of my feelings on that. So it's not a cure-all. It's not a, I can hunt that stand every day because my scent's not there. You still got to be smart, not pressure the deer. But it helps. I'm not one to... I hate washing my clothes all the time. I hate spraying down all the time. I hate storing them in weird places just to keep scent down. It's too much of a hassle for me. And when I used to do that, I just got frustrated and got sick of doing that. So as far as my clothes go, my boots, all my gear, other than throwing them in a dry wash bag and letting the Ozonics run, I do nothing else. I walk right into my house with them and take them off and put them in the man cave and put them back on. So I'm not doing anything as far as scent elimination on that side of things. I hunt the wind, and this Ozonics seems to be helping too. So it's kind of fun. It's easy. I'd rather have to carry that into the woods and put it up in the tree. That's a lot easier than spraying down and doing all that scent control stuff. Some people believe in scent control, others don't. I like this device because it's at least it's mixing the ozone with your scent when it leaves you and helping to dilute it. So it's pretty cool, but I'm going to sit here for another 20 minutes, see if anything comes out, and then I'm going to sneak down. I'm going to leave my set home, leave my camera arm, leave everything up here, kind of. Other than my bag and bow, and run over and check that camera real quick and get out of here. I'm gonna hunt it again on Friday morning and see what happens. Might not see anything then either, but this isn't a spot that I expect to see a lot of deer. It's just kind of a spot that when I do see one, I think it's gonna be a mature buck, so, or one of the 3.5-year-olds that I'm after. So there's 3 deer that I'm after, and we name them just to keep them organized when I'm talking to my buddies or my wife or the kids, which buck I saw. So there's Mario, he's a 3.5-year-old 8-point. There's Booger, He's a 3.5-year-old eight-point that probably goes 130. Mario's just a poor genetic deer, but he has a good frame, just real short tongs. And then Widowmaker, same deal, kind of flat up top, but heavy, wide. Not going to score real well, but he has really long beams and kind of like a chocolate rack with all gnarled up, so he's a pretty cool deer. I'll be happy with any three of those. They're all 3.5-year-olds. And right now, that's kind of my standard for my property, is kill 3.5-year-olds, not 2.5-year-olds. Dad hunted on Saturday evening. No. Monday evening, Dad was first set. He came out and set and passed up a nice 9-point that's a 2.5-year-old. And it was the biggest deer he's ever passed up, ever. Let alone with a trad bow at 4 yards, I think he had it. So I'm proud of him for that. It was a buck that I saw Saturday also, but again, I'm after some mature deer. Not that it's awesome. Mark will shoot anything that's legal, and that's cool too. I probably would too if I was only hunting public land. Maybe not, but I'm fortunate enough to be able to manage some deer here on my property, so it's fun either way. Have a good day, guys. Well, it's Friday morning. Always have to have coffee. It's 5:30 and feel like hunting this morning, but I'm following that DeerCast app this year from the juries, just for the heck of it. I kind of take into consideration most of the stuff they do, but I'm sure they know more than me, so following that. It says it's going to be great this morning. I believe the pressure is climbing until 9 o'clock, which I have to get down before 9 o'clock, but the wind will be a northeast, which is a iffy wind for that spot. But an iffy wind, if I see something, it might bust me by the time I get to shoot it. However, my scent won't be blowing into the bedding area. So, same spot as on Wednesday. Not really expecting much, but I'm going to get out there. So, get my clothes on. I'll see you in the tree. The wind that I expect him to use to come through here, but it's also the wind that kind of puts me in jeopardy also, so it's an iffy wind. I have to climb down around that time to go to work anyways, so I thought, maybe he'll scoot through here this morning, but as soon as that wind switches, I might have to get out of here, so. Starting to switch right now is ideal, so my wind's just going this way and I'm expecting them to come this way, so it kind of puts you in a position where, you know, with a mature deer, a 3.5-year-old, for instance, the wind has to be perfect for them and almost wrong for you. I truly believe that, so it's where the Ozonics, I think, helps. Just keep all morning here and just keep throwing out milkweed, watching the wind and making sure it's not totally wrong for me. And as soon as it is totally wrong for me, I'll probably get out of here. So either way, it's a fun morning, Friday morning. Like I said, I'm in here after three deer, but in this spot here, I have a possibility of killing probably two of them, so it's a low odds stand. I don't expect to see a lot of deer, but if I do see one, it'll probably be one of the two, but one of the three. This morning's kind of chilly. It's 60 degrees, but the wind's like 4 or 5 mile an hour. And I have the same thing on I had Wednesday morning. Merino bases, Ascent pants, Ascent top. Or actually, lightweight hoodie on top with my Merino. And this morning, 60 degrees, high pressure, with a little bit of a wind, about 5 mile an hour. I probably should have worn my Apex stuff. Still staying in the subalpine. I think it's, you know, a better color for early season. I know deer can't see color, but they can see shades and whatnot, so I think it just blends in a little better. But November comes, I'll be switching to elevated too. I'm gonna sit it out here for the next hour and see. Well guys, the wind switched on me earlier than I thought, which is fine because I underdressed this morning for sure. I should have wore my storm front jacket or something with a little Gore-Tex in it. The wind's just going right through me this morning, so wind switched quicker than I thought, probably an hour before I thought. So shortly after I got off that last clip, I climbed down out. Not worth risking it this early. I probably put myself in a little more jeopardy than what I wanted to. So packing up, getting out of here, and headed to work. Everybody that's tuning into this vlog, thanks for watching. If there's anything you want to see that we're not documenting, let us know. But we're just kind of doing our daily life with hunting primarily in some of our daily lives. So click the subscribe button and stay safe and shoot straight.